Hi, this is Rufa Gutierrez, and this is my mega story. I have grown up in front of the cameras, and I've been in this industry since I was 13, so my life is an open book. It depends on how much you want to reveal. You can reveal 20% of yourself, 100% of yourself. As much as I want to hide things, I can only hide so much because, you know, my mom talks a lot, and I talk a lot, and, you know, I mean, things just happen to come out in the press, even if you want to hide it, even if you're very careful. I decided to take up Secret and Spies just because, you know, it talks about media, it talks about the changes now that we have in our society when it comes to dealing with the internet. I just thought that the course was interesting. You know, it's not any given day that a lot of the universities offer this course. So I've learned a lot about that because it also has something to do with my industry as well, especially all of us, the youth. You know, we're all into our computers, social media. I still believe that each and every one of us have a public life, a personal life, and a secret life. You know, a few years ago, I said, no, I don't want to get married again. I'll just rather have a boyfriend. And, you know, when things don't work out, you go your separate ways, and that's it. But this year, in a matter of 1 month, there was like 4 of my friends that got married, and I said, oh, I want to get married again. The thing is, I don't have a prospect yet. For me, I guess I've changed my opinion about getting married. I said I've been there, done that. But when you see people in love, when you see couples that love each other, that make that pact and they walk down the aisle and they do it, you know, in front of God, I want to have my happy ending too. I've worked with family before, but not the entire family all together in a reality show. We are not the traditional, old school kind of family. It's one big, exciting experience, and at the same time, very stressful because we have a lot of very fierce, very strong personalities. And I've realized that we're not the same people we were 5 years ago, 10 years ago. Everyone's grown up. You can see that we're not so young anymore, you know? All of us are getting old and everyone has their own lives and their own problems. So with all of us coming together, I can say it's, you know, liberating to work with them. Well, I've always said that I look up to the Kardashians. You know, people may think the worst of them or the best of them, but I can say that we're different. It's just that we're just more Filipino, we're just more Asian. Well, you know, the Pinoys nowadays, they're so talented. And whatever we do, you know, it's always talked about. You know, it's really just getting our name out there, representing our country, doing the best thing that we possibly can, and showing the world that we Pinoys can also shine. And it's happening right now because there's a lot of global Pinoys out there that are making our country proud.
Like a moth to a flame, trouble keeps on finding me. I've been hiding from my